Okay. So these simple pictures shows the ampullae of Lorenzini, and what are they consist of? This is a real picture, and it shows the canal, the sensory cells, and the nerves. Same things apply here, with minor changes, that I have done to overcome the engineering challenges of biomimicking the ampullae of Lorenzini. As you can see on the prototype, the canal, the ampulla, and the nerves. Here is a clip. While I was mounting the electroreceptors organs 2 in place, ready for testing. I will start here by testing the electroreceptors with a 5 volts DC signal. That is going through the magnet wire on the far right. Up on the screen, you will see the power state. Whether it's on or off. And in the bottom of the screen, slight right, you will see the plotter. Which is picking up the signals through the electroreceptors, and we'll see the response there. As you can see. On the plotter, when a 5V is applied. You can see the higher reading on the plotter. Thus, meaning that we are getting the reading through the electroreceptors. This is just a reference prop that I am using, it's because in main time, I am testing different configurations to see which one is the best. To test which configuration will get me the highest sensitivity results. I also want to test what is the minimum voltage I can detect with such system. So, we have distance of 20 cm plus, as you can see right there. See the reading. The signal is detected due to the electric field that is generated from the current passing through the magnet wire, far left here, with the electroreceptors in the other end. By the way, this is normal tap water that I am testing with. I will be adding this cup of sodium chloride, basically salt, so that I can simulate seawater. However, seawater is not 100% sodium chloride. On average, seawater in the world's oceans has a salinity of approximately 3.5%, or 35 parts per thousand. This means that for every 1 liter, 1000 ml of seawater, there are 35 grams of salt, mostly, but not entirely sodium chloride, dissolved in it. So yeah, that's what I have, and what I will be simulating the seawater with. Okay. Moving to the next step, I will shut down the power supply now. I will try now to lower the voltage to 1V and test again. Alright, so testing for 1V starting. As you can see, we have a reading there as shown by the rising edge on the plotter. Okay, now I will be testing for 100 millivolts. Test starts. Again, there is a response. Cool stuff. You can see the power supply jumping up to 300 millivolts and then back down to zero, causing a noise with the readings. See plotter signal. But this is what I had to test with. I will be testing again with lower voltages and greater distances on a future upcoming prototype. I would like to take a moment here. If you are interested on this project, and you are looking for more information, then visit my website, as I have written everything there in much more detail. You will find there links to the files for the molding parts, as well as the steps I have taken to build these ampullae of Lorenzini electroreceptors prototype. See detail in the video description. Now for the final test, that will be included in this video. This time I will put my hand into the water. While the power supply is off, just to see if I can get any reading. And as you can see, indeed, I am getting a reading. This is interesting. As for now, I am satisfied with the early results. And I am looking forward to see what other things I may achieve with such system. Until the next prototype, I bid you farewell. Peace.